To wrap up today's talk, an abstract data type is defined by syntax and the semantics of the operations, and the type of object values that it can hold, and its properties. We have basic containers. They are defined by the access, storage, and traversal behavior. The implementation of an abstract data type defines the time complexity of the operations. We have seen three basic types. Stack supports pop and push operation in terms of an ADT. Array is great to append to it, but it's really bad to insert in between because you have to shift stuff around. Lists use our pointer concepts, and they're really cool. And lastly, whenever we use an API, we have to think about who owns the memory when we put in pointers. So we have to understand the API specification, and that's a little bit cumbersome in C. Nevertheless, I hope you found today's lecture very pleasing and enjoyable, and I chose you how we can make good use of this dynamic memory allocations, how we use pointers effectively to make some bigger data structures that have a benefit. And data structures ultimately are really beneficial to a lot of algorithms because they allow to accelerate the runtime of them in terms of complexity theory. All right, wish you a nice week and see you soon.